Now let us take a bridge course about the chemistry. Lecture 1 we will call for this. So here we are going to discuss about atoms, ions and molecules. Okay, all these are known concepts. Even we are going to brush up the things that you already learned in your previous classes. Okay, so before going to the definitions of all these, so let us begin with a famous theory called Dalton's theory of atoms. That means Dalton is a famous scientist. He has attempted for the first time in order to define what do you mean by atom, and also he has given the theory of atom that is known as Dalton's theory of atoms. Okay, now the same thing you are going to study in the first lesson as well. So what he said, Dalton? Dalton said that, so matter, anything that occupies the space is known as what? Matter, right? That matter is made up of a tiny particles which cannot be divisible further. That indivisible tiny particle of a matter is known as atom. Okay, atom andre, any, if you consider any matter, that matter is made up of a tiny, not divisible, indivisible particle. That indivisible particle of a matter, enanta kartha, that they call, he called it as a atom. Okay, that means atom is a fundamental particle present in all the matter. And that means if I take a matter, if you go on dividing the matter into small, small pieces, the final and ultimate particle that results, that cannot be further divisible, that minute tiny particle is said as what? Atom. Okay. So then, and he also said some of the properties of the atom. Like, atoms of the given element are identical in mass and their chemical properties. That means, so if you consider any element, for example, if you consider gold element. So gold element, na, you can consider in India or you can go for any other countries. The gold will be having same properties. Okay, that is atoms of the given element are identical mass. That is the mass of the gold is constant in the universe. That will not change from place to place. Okay, that is called atom of the given elements are identical mass. Since they have identical mass, they have a same chemical properties. Yes or no? If the gold Indian behave, yava country no, the gold property will not change. That is the meaning of it. That is, atoms of the given elements are identical in mass and the chemical properties. That is, atoms of different elements are different, in mass and chemical properties. That means the property that possessed by gold is not similar to that of the properties which possessed by the iron. Yes or no? Iron property is different, gold property is different, silver property is different, platinum property is different, carbon property is different. Like that, atoms of the different elements possess different masses and hence they have a different chemical properties. Next, so what he said is, during the chemical reactions, in the chemical reactions what happens? There is a combination reaction, decomposition reaction, metal displacement reaction. In all those chemical reactions, what happens? There is a reorganization of the atoms. Atoms say nagate, reorganization nagate, but total number of atoms is conserved during the chemical reaction. That means no atom cannot be prepared, atom cannot be created, neither be destroyed during the chemical reaction. Yen agate, just transfer agate, one form in the unknown form here, chemical transfer agate during the chemical reaction. And also he said that in atom, an atom combines in a small or small whole number ratio to form a compound. Like for example, if I take H2O molecule, here 2 is to 1. Two atoms of hydrogen combines with one atom of oxygen. In H2S also, two atoms of hydrogen combines with one atom of sulfur. They will be combining in such a way that they will be maintaining a small whole number ratio. That he said. Few other postulates already in the first as well as in the second lesson of your first PUC. Okay, this is about the first theory, that is Dalton's atomic theory. Why we need to know all about this atomic theory? Because it's a fundamental theory of what we can say physics or chemistry, we'll say about atom, the first time explained by Dalton. That's why you should have the concept of Dalton's atomic theory. Okay, now we will be entering to the definition of what do you mean by atoms, ions and the molecules. Known concept, anyway we will study. As I already told, atom is a tiny particle of a matter which consisting of a positively charged nucleus in which nucleons are present. Nucleons means protons and neutrons are embedded in the nucleus of an atom and electrons are revolving around that positively charged nucleus. So, in a particular part known as orbit. What do you mean by atom? Atom is a basic unit of matter which consists of central nucleus where proton neutrons are placed, and around the nucleus, there's nucleus is surrounded by negatively charged electrons, right? So, when the atom anta nimge heltakshane, so you have to imagine an atom consisting of positively charged small nucleus at the center, around that positively charged nucleus, negatively charged electrons are revolving. In the center of the nucleus where protons and neutrons are present, so around the nucleus electrons are revolving. Yes or no? Next, example for the atoms like hydrogen, carbon, sodium, sulfur, Au, Ag, etc. Whatever the elements which are there in the periodic table, you can give the example for the atoms. Next question is, so I am asking you, will the atom have an independent existence? No, the answer is no. Why it is no? Because anything you consider, any matter you consider, so atoms are very, very small. So that means we cannot extract or we cannot take out a single isolated atom. It is very, very difficult. The independent existence of the atom is not there. Okay. That atom is always in the combined state. Okay. So that means, so atom independent existence is not possible for the atom. So atoms may be in the form of cluster. Okay, or they may be in the form of combined state. So atoms of the noble gas will be having independent existence. That is helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon. They all will be having noble gases. What do we call? They will be having independent existence. They will be exist in the atomic form. Okay. Next, so what do you mean by molecules then? Molecules are the smallest particle of substance. So that molecule may be formed from element or compound. Element and the elements and the atoms of the same. Okay. The elements means element is made up of same type of atoms. Compounds means, so compounds are made up of two or more type of atoms. Like for example H2, N2, they're all elements. That is, they will be having same type of atom. When we come to the compounds, for example H2O, H2S, CO2, CH4, they are compounds because they are formed from two or more different atoms, right? That means molecules are the smallest particles of a substance, so that may be elements or compounds which have a free existence, right? Molecules of free existence there. Atomic free existence illa, molecules will be having a free existence. So atoms of the same or different elements combines with each other to form a molecules. For example, here same atoms are same type of atoms. Hydrogen atoms are combined to form hydrogen molecule. Here two nitrogen atoms are combined to form N2 molecule. S8, sulfur 8, 8 sulfur atoms are combined to form SO2, S8. Similarly, H2O and SO2, so etc. They are formed from two different atoms. Look here, hydrogen is different, oxygen is different. This is formed from the combination of two different atoms. Okay, that is, these are called compounds, these are called elements. Okay, so next we will be discussing about ions, molecules. Okay, now we already said the definitions of elements and compounds. The definitions are like this. Element means it is a cluster of same type of atoms or molecules. Okay, example hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, etc. Compounds means it is a cluster of different types of elements combined in a fixed ratio. For example, H2O, HCl and CO2. That means, so if I take a cluster means what, a combination. So in cluster, hydrogen molecule. So hydrogen molecule. So like this, n number of hydrogen molecules will be there in this cluster. No, same type. This is a molecule which is formed from the same type of atom, right? That is known as element. Okay. Similarly, cluster of the molecules which are formed from different elements. For example, so here one molecule of H2O, here another molecule of H2O, here another molecule of H2O. It's a cluster of molecules. This molecule is formed from two different elements which are combined by fixed ratio. Fixed ratio, and then look here in the H2O, two atoms of hydrogen combines with one atom of oxygen. That means they are combined in doing so by maintaining a fixed ratio. Similarly, in HCl, one atom of H combined with one atom of chlorine. These are also molecules. These molecules are formed from different atoms. The cluster of the molecules which are formed from two or more different elements are known as water compounds. But if you see the elements is also composed of molecules. Those molecules are formed from a same type of atoms. Look here, this is a cluster of hydrogen. So if I see the hydrogen molecules, same type of atoms are there. Hope it is clear regarding what you mean by these elements and the compounds, right? So next, valency. A very, very important concept. Valency, you might have learned about this valency in your previous classes and all. So what do you mean by valency? So valency is defined as, it is a combining capacity of an element. So it is a combining capacity of an element, and it is equal to the number of hydrogen atom with which the atom of element combines. What is the meaning of this? Look at here, H2O. Here oxygen atom combines with two atoms of hydrogen. So the valency of oxygen is 2 in this. Okay. So valency of oxygen is 2. Because an atom, to that atom, how many hydrogen atoms are attached? Or to how many number of hydrogen atom an atom combines is nothing but its valency. Okay, with respect to hydrogen also we can say, with respect to fluorine also we can say, with respect to oxygen also we can say. For simplicity, I have taken hydrogen. So valency means it's a combining capacity of an element. See, why element has to combine then? Why they have to show the valencies? So we know that in the periodic table. So students, we know that in the periodic table, so 111, 112 elements are there, still more are there. So 112 stable elements are there in the periodic table, right? In those elements, we call the noble gas family, they are what you can say, they are stable elements. Yes or no? Noble gases, we'll say, are inert gases. That means the noble gases are highly stable elements present in the periodic table. Why noble gases are very stable then? So, they're inert. They won't combine. Why noble gases are stable? Because, so except helium, rest of the elements of the noble gas family will be having 8 electrons in the valence shell. Is it no? So what do you mean by valence shell then? So we know that if you imagine an atom and imagine it consisting of a positively charged nucleus, and around that positively charged nucleus electrons are revolving in a circular path, right? So what do you mean by valence electron? So valence electron is one in which is present at the last shell of an atom. Valence electron anta karibekandre a electron atom in a last shell alli irbeku. The outermost electron, the outermost electron of an atom is known as what? A valence electron. Okay, so that shell is known as valence shell. Okay, every atom in the periodic table have a urge or have a tendency to achieve 8 electrons in the outermost shell. Why? Because if they achieve 8 electrons in the outermost shell, then they become stable. Then they become stable because they becomes nearest noble gas. That means if I see the noble gas electronic configuration, all the noble gases except helium will be having doublet structure. Rest of them like neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon, if you see the electronic configuration of those noble gases, they will have a 8 electrons or octet structure in the valence shell. Okay, every element have a tendency to achieve that 8 electrons in the outermost shell. So that's why they will combine, that's why they will show the valency. People understanding? So we can say that the valence electron, valence shell, every element have a tendency to achieve the 8 electrons so that they become a noble gas and they become chemically inert and become very stable. So in order to achieve that 8 electrons in the outermost shell, they will combine with other element and forming the molecules. Okay, people understanding? So and also they will exhibit valency. Look here, H2O, if I see oxygen, if I take the oxygen, what is the atomic number of oxygen? 8 electrons are there. If I write the electronic configuration of oxygen, 1s2, 2s2 and 2p. So 8 electrons are there, right? 4, 6, 7, 8. How many we have to write here? 4 electrons, right? So look here in the last shell, valence shell, how many electrons are there? 4 plus 2, 6 electrons are there. How many electrons are shortage for the oxygen to become 8? 2 electrons are shortage for an oxygen to become a noble gas, right? So that's why by accepting 2 electrons, it will be exhibiting 2 minus 2. So minus 2, but valency is 2 on the togotivi. Combining capacity is 2. So that means by accepting 2 electrons from 2 hydrogen, it becomes noble gas. Becomes 8 electrons in the outermost shell. So oxygen exhibit 2 valency because to become a octet structure at the last shell, that is at the valence shell. So combining capacity of oxygen is 2. You understanding? So it is observed that in the periodic table, those elements which have a valence electron 1, 2, 3, 4, so they will be exhibiting so valency equal to valence electrons. Okay, so those elements, that is the elements which have a 1 electrons in the last shell, 2 electrons in the last shell, 3 electrons in the last shell, that is valence shell, and 4 electrons in the last shell, their combining capacity is equal to the valence electron. And then 1 valence electron is there, and then the valency kuda 1 there. Okay, 2 valence electrons are there, means the combining capacity or valency of that element is 2. 3 valence electrons are there, means the valency is 3. 4 valence electrons are there, means its valency is 4. So those elements which have 5 valence electrons, 5, 6, 7 and 8 valence electron, their valency is equal to 8 minus valence electrons. Their valency is equal to 8 minus the valence electron. That means 5 valence electron is there, 8 minus 5, 3 is the valency of that nitrogen family. There are 5 valence electrons for the nitrogen, right? So the 5, 6, 7, 8 valence electrons गल इदे अदु valency एनागुत्ते अथवा combined capacity एनागुत्ते अंद्रे which is equal to 8 minus valence electron that means so 5 minus 8 minus 5 is 3 3 is the valency of those elements which have 5 valence electron 6 is and this 8 minus 6 is 2 for example oxygen I told so 8 minus 6 is 2 2 is a combining capacity so 8 minus 7 1 halogen family 1 is a combining capacity as 1 is a valency okay so 8 minus 8 noble gases will have how many electrons in the valence shell 8 valence electrons in the outermost shell right 8 minus 8 is 0 that's why the combined capacity is 0 they won't exhibit any valency 0 will be the valency of the noble gases yes or no so this is a general way to predict the valency of the elements which are there in the periodic table hope it is clear valency means is a combining capacity of an element that means the an element to how many atoms of the hydrogen it is combined that is also equal to its valency last class we have explained about the valency so and valence electron right so here is a table which consisting of various elements some common elements and their valencies and their symbols look at this table elements metal names sodium potassium silver magnesium and then it will follow still aluminium so here are the symbols of them sodium potassium silver is symbolized as Ag magnesium as Mg calcium as Ca barium as Ba Pb and Zn copper Ag for mercury nickel Ni manganese Mn iron Fe An aluminium Al like that still this still more elements also we can include for this table so look at the valency of these elements sodium look at the valency of sodium it is 1 why it is 1 see look at sodium so we know that sodium the atomic number of sodium is 11 right so if you write the electronic configuration of sodium 1s2 2s2 and so what happens 4 and 2p6 and 3s1 okay I already told you all the elements have a tendency to acquire octet electronic configuration in the outermost shell look at the sodium here so how many so there is one electron extra if this electron is lost by the sodium then it becomes 6 plus 2 8 octet electronic configuration so what happens sodium will be converted into N8+ by releasing one electron that one extra electron will be removed now what is the configuration of sodium 1s2 2s2 and 2p6 see look at the 8 electrons at the ultimate shell that is outermost shell now it becomes stable keep understanding so like that so many elements for example magnesium if you take any element you take magnesium if I take so 12 is atomic number so if you write the electronic configuration 1s2 2s2 and 2p6 and 3s2 so since it is a metal metals have a tendency to lose the electron because they are electropositive in nature so what happens these two electrons are lost by losing two electrons magnesium becomes Mg2+ by the loss of two electrons and hence it achieves what octet electronic configuration in the outermost shell yes or no so that's why valency of this magnesium is taken as 2 look here 2 and so here few elements are there look here lead so two valencies 2 also possible 4 also is possible here also copper mercury and also like manganese 3 oxidation state it will exhibit so here also sulfur will exhibit 3 oxidation state and few elements in this table you can observe more than one valency is possible for them right so along with the common valency they will be exhibiting some other valencies also why it is so then so we know that so an atom if we take an atom if we imagine an atom we know that center at the center of the nucleus there is a presence of nucleus around that what so electrons are revolving in a circular path so like this we are going to imagine an atom right so The last shell is called what? Ultimate shell. Ultimate shell, or is we call it as valency shell. So valency shell anta kalithivi alva. So here, if the element loses one electron, one or more electron in the ultimate shell, then it will exhibit only one valency. Okay, for example, sodium and magnesium, they will lose the electrons which are present at the ultimate shell, or else the valence shell. So they will be exhibiting the valency as only one, that is either one only. Look here, only one valency is possible for them. So the next shell, last but next shell anta kalithivalva, last shell jothege inner shell, next shell, that is called penultimate shell. What do we call? Penultimate shell. Penultimate shell. So if an element loses electron both in the ultimate shell as well as in the penultimate shell, then that element will be exhibiting more than one valency. Okay, so the for example sulfur and manganese, all these elements will loses the electron of the valence shell. Along with that, the electron of the penultimate shell is also take part in bonding. That means also what involving in, so the loss or gain of electron. During that case, they will be exhibiting more than one valency. That you have to understand. Why one few elements will be having so more than one valency? Because of this reason. People understanding? Ultimate shell jothege penultimate shell alli electrons galu kuda involve agutte, illi in bond formation anta kalithivi. Whenever they both the electrons of penultimate and ultimate shells are involving, they will be exhibiting more than one valency. Okay, hope it is clear. So then for example, for this also we will be taking one example. So what example I am going to take? For example, manganese I am going to take, and I am going to illustrate you. So let us take a manganese elements in this table. So manganese, so if we take, is a D block element. Generally, the elements of D block and a few elements of the P block will be exhibiting variable valency. And then, ಒಂದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ವೇರಿಯನ್ಸ್ ನ ಎಕ್ಸಿಬಿಟ್ ಮಾಡೋ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಗಳು ಜನರಲಿ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಷನ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಫ್ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಫ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ದ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪಿ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಎಕ್ಸಿಬಿಟಿಂಗ್ ಮೋರ್ ದೆನ್ ಒನ್ ವೇರಿಯನ್ಸಿ. ಸೊ ನೌ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಮ್ಯಾಂಗನೀಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಅನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್. ಮ್ಯಾಂಗನೀಸ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ನಂಬರ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಸೀ ದ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಂಗನೀಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ 25. Okay, if you write the electronic configuration of the manganese, so 1s2 and 2s2, 2p6 and 3s2, 3p6, and so we can write 4s2. So actually we know that according to the principle, in the previous class we have discussed, according to AFPA principle, how to write the electronic configuration you have learned, no? According to that, so 4s should be completely filled, then only electron will be entering to the 3d level, right? So that's why while writing, you can write 3d first followed by, so what, 4s. But 4s is on a lower energy compared to 3d according to n plus l rule. So 4s electron first filled, so remaining electron will be occupying d shell, that is 5, remaining 5 electrons will be present in the d shell. So I told you manganese will be exhibiting what? So here look at this table, manganese 2, 4, 7 I have written. So it will exhibit 2 valency, 4 valency and 7 valency is possible for manganese. Why? Because manganese becomes manganese 2. Manganese plus 2 na yavag exhibit madutte. So if it loses the electron from 4s subshell, that is ultimate shell. If understanding, this is called ultimate shell or else valence shell. Valence shell alli iruvanta 2 electron, if it loses that 2 electron, it will be exhibiting so plus 2 oxidation state. So for example, so MnO, compound MnO, here Mn will be in plus 2 oxidation state. Here the loss of electron takes place from the ultimate shell. So, when the elements will be exhibiting more than one valency or variable valency, if the ultimate electron and penultimate electrons both are taking part in the bond formation. So what happens? Mn becomes Mn enagutte. It becomes Mn plus 7. Mn becomes Mn plus 7. When all the electrons 2 plus 5, 5 electrons from penultimate shell, 2 electrons from ultimate shell, both the electrons are lost. That time Mn becomes Mn 7 plus, that is plus 7 oxidation state. So for example, KMnO4 compound. Look at the oxidation state of manganese, it is plus 7 here. Understanding? So here KMnO4 only plus 7 with the oxidation state. So like that, Mn can also exhibit plus 4. So Mn becomes Mn plus 4 when, so if it loses 4 electrons, that is 2 electrons from S subshell, that is ultimate shell, and another 2 electrons is from penultimate shell. So when it loses 4 electrons, it becomes Mn 4 plus. So for example, so MnO2, compound called MnO2, here MnO2 oxidation state of manganese is plus 4, that is due to the involvement of or loss of electron from ultimate shell and the 2 electrons from penultimate shell, like that. So few elements in the periodic table exhibit more than one valency, that is due to the loss of electron from ultimate shell as well as penultimate shell, that you have to understand. Rest of them will be exhibiting one valency, like S block elements in the current table, electropositive element, they will be having only one valency, either 1 or 2. Alkali metals will exhibit one valency, alkaline earth metals will be exhibiting plus 2 valency. More than one valency is not possible for them because they only ultimate shell is involving in the bond formation. Penultimate shell is not involving in the bond formation. Whenever penultimate shell is involving in the bond formation, they will be exhibiting more than one valency. Generally, this is commonly the D block element or transition elements are trying to exhibit this variable valencies. And few elements of the P block also exhibit a variable oxidation state due to inert pair effect at the current way. Now, what do you mean by that inert pair effect? At the, we will be discussing in detail in the theory. In general, so the, if the valence electrons of the metals of any element, not only metals, if the element consisting of 1, 2, 3 valence electron, if the valence electron is 1, then that is 1, 2, 3, they have a tendency to lose the electron. Okay, like 1 and the alkali metals, 2 and the alkaline earth metals, next to aluminium family. So if the valence electrons are 1, 2 and 3, these elements will have a tendency to lose the electron because they are electropositive in nature. Okay, so that's why if it loses one electron, its valency is plus 1. If it loses 2 electrons, then the valency becomes plus 2. If it loses 3 electrons, then the valency becomes plus 3. Yes or no? For example, so if you want example, like I have already given sodium as example and magnesium as an example. Now I will take just aluminium as an example. What is atomic number of aluminium? 13, right? If you write the electronic configuration of aluminium, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 10 it becomes. Then what happens? 3s2 and 3p1. Okay, look at this. How many valence electrons are there? Valence electrons are 3. That's why it loses 3 electrons. Then that becomes aluminium 3 plus. By the release of 3 electrons, by the loss of 3 electrons, and hence it becomes. So what happens to the outermost electronic configuration? 2s2 and 2p6 it becomes, right? That is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. How many electrons are there in the outermost shell? 8 electrons. Okay. Why they will exhibit valency? To achieve a 8 electron or octet electronic configuration in the outermost shell, and has to become a noble gas and become a stable. So that's why aluminium exhibit plus 3 as valency, and it has a more tendency to lose the electron, and hence exhibit the valency of plus 3. Similarly, so if the valence electron electrons are like 5, 6 and 7. Okay, 5 yavadakke nitrogen family. And the first element of that group is nitrogen. That's why we say it as nitrogen family. Nitrogen family in the valence electrons are 5 valence electrons are there. So next to 6, oxygen family. Okay, they are also known as chalcogens. Chalcogens. Because halogen is Indian group. Chalcogens. 7 valence electron in a group ke naavu halogen family anta karithivalva. This if the valence electrons are 5, 6 and 7, generally they have a tendency to gain the electron. Okay, generally they have a tendency to gain the electron and they will exhibit the valency of -3, -2, -1. Haage tagolala naavu. Generally naavu calculation alli -3, -2, -1 anta tagondivi. Valency anta tagondaga charge na neglect maartivi. So here also we are going to neglect the charge. That's why valency is taken as 1, 2 and 3. So if the element has a valence electron 4, then it never lose or never gain the electron. It has a tendency to chase the electron. A very good example for this is carbon family. Okay, because of this reason only carbon forms a huge number of compounds, because of its nature that it's going to be chase the electron with other elements. Okay, so carbon family, since they have a 4 valence electron in the outermost shell, they chase the electron and hence the valency is taken as 4. Okay, so for example, second one gains electron. Yeah, I will be giving you one more example for your understanding purpose. For to explain this gain of electron, I will be taking one example of oxygen. We know the atomic number of oxygen, that is 8. If you write the electronic configuration, it becomes 1s2, 2s2, 2p4, right? So look at the outermost electrons, that is the electron present in the ultimate shell, RN, so valence shell. Yes, electron is there, but 6 electrons are there. So, here, nimge anusutte. So, why it accept or gains 2 electron? If it accept 2 more electron, it becomes octet. That is easy, right? So compared to the loss of 4 plus 2, 6 electron and becomes helium, like 1s doublet structure. So it is easy to accept 2 electron, right? That's why it shows acceptancy, not like the loss of electron, like aluminium. Artha aagtidya? Andre, 2 electron tagolodu easy idakke. Compared to the loss of how many? 4 plus 2, 6 electrons loss markup, it becomes stable. Otherwise, if it accepts 2 electrons, it is also becomes stable, right? It is also achieving noble gas electronic configuration. That's why it shows the tendency to gain 2 electrons. By gaining 2 electrons, it becomes O2 minus. That is, by acceptance minus minus charge barate, loss markup, plus charge barate. By accepting 2 electrons, it becomes water 1s2, 2s2, 2p6. Look at this. It achieves 8 electrons in the outer motion. Okay. So, but here, carbon. Carbon, if I take carbon family, that will shares on the energy. Not losses, not gains. Why? See, so look at the carbon. So, carbon, what is atomic number of carbon? It is 6, right? So, if you write the electronic configuration, 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. Sorry, 2p2. So, look here. So, here, if you see the number of valence electrons in the last shell, it is ultimate shell, how many electrons are there? 4 electrons are there, right? So, either it has to accept 4 electrons, or else it has to lose that 4 electron, become stable. By the loss of this 4 electron, it becomes doublet structure, like helium, and becomes stable. Or else, by the acceptance of 4 more electrons, it becomes 8 electron and becomes again stable, becomes octet. That's why, because of this, what happens, the special nature of carbon is that it shares the electron with other element. For example, it shares in methane. So, it forms a covalent bond. Okay, look here. So, hydrogen, 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 hydrogen. Methane, carbon do 4 electrons. These are the 4 electrons of the carbon, and it will shares with 4 hydrogen. This another electron is from hydrogen. So look at the total number of electrons for the carbon: 2, 4, 6, 8. And hydrogen also becomes 2 doublet. Yes or no? By sharing electron, it touches octet electronic configuration. You know that, right? So like this, you have to understand this table to predict the valency of the elements. So few variable valencies are all, as I already told you, few variable valencies are due to the loss of electron from ultimate as well as pen hydrogenation. So radicals, when we will be taking the next concept, that is about radical. So what are radicals? Radicals are electrically charged species. That means these are the species which carry electrical charges, plus or minus. Okay. So these are the atoms or group of atoms carrying electric charge. In that we will be having two types: positively charged radical, so, and negatively charged radical. So positive radical, when a metal loses one or more electron, it forms what? Positive charge. That is, it becomes positively charged radical. For example, sodium becomes Na plus, calcium becomes calcium 2 plus. Okay. So like that. So this is a cation radical. This is called as cation because it is having, so plus those ions which have a positive charge is also known as a cations. Okay. So similarly, the name positive radical, the name of the positively radical is same as that of the metal. For example, Na is there, sodium anta odidre, the radical ayi gottivi sodium ion anta odtivi. Idana calcium anta odtilva, ava ion annu kuda calcium ion anta odtivi aste. Okay? So illi ondu note, important note ide. I told you some elements will be exhibiting more than one valency due to the participation of both ultimate and penultimate electrons. So, if an element shows variable valencies, then the names of the element in higher and lower valency states are indicated by words ending with IC and OUS. So, that is, what we can say is generally, the higher oxidation state, that if the element in its higher oxidation state is ending with IC. Look here, copper as an example. Here, copper can exhibit plus 1 and plus 2, right? If it is in higher oxidation state of plus 2, then it is named as cuprine. It's in this lower oxidation state, it is named as OUS, cuprous and cupric. Okay, so the cuprous and cupric. So similarly for iron also, this is 2 plus and 3 plus. 2 plus state in the lower, it is a higher. Lower oxidation state is OUS, higher oxidation state is IC. That is ferric ferrous. Iron 3 plus is ferric, iron 2 plus is ferrous, like that. As we discussed about elements, compounds, and also so different types of what element, basics of that, no? So now we are going to discuss about radicals. Okay, what are radicals? So in chemistry, you what we can say while discussing the syllabus, you will be come across with this radicals also, right? So first of all, we should know what do you mean by a radical. A radical is a electrically charged species. That means radical is a it is a species which carries positive or negative charge. That species is known as what? A radical. So simple, we say that radicals are the electrically charged species. They may have positive charge or they may have a negative charge. These radicals are going to be classified into two types: positively charged radical and negatively charged radical. Okay, what do you mean by positively charged radical? Name itself will suggest that these are the radical which possesses positive, net positive charge on it. Then they are called positively charged radical. Example, when sodium ionizes to form Na plus by the release of one electron, a sodium positive ion, that is sodium radical, is going to be formed. Similarly, calcium 2 plus, calcium radical is going to be formed. So the name of this positively charged radical is same as that of the name of the element. That is, in a sodium anta ottive, in a sodium radical anta ottive. So this is, we say it is calcium, this is called calcium radical, like that. Name of the radical is same as that of the name of the
element. Okay, so for example, so in the previous class while discussing, we have discussed one table, right? Few of the elements of D block elements and also P block element have a tendency to exhibit variable oxidation state. That is, more than one oxidation state they will exhibit, right? So if that case, if that case what happens, if a cation will be present in two or more oxidation state, then the cation R is the positive radical with the lower oxidation state is ending with OUS. The radical, the positive radical with higher oxidation state is ending with IC. Okay, so lower oxidation state is US. Okay, like that we are going to say. For example, so look here, copper will be present in two oxidation state, that is in plus 2 state and plus 1 state. In plus 2 state we name it as a cupric, and in plus 1 state we name it as cuprous. Okay, cupric and cuprous. Similarly, so in mercury will be present in two oxidation state or two valencies, that is in plus 1 state and plus 2 state. Plus 1 is called lower oxidation state, that is ending with OUS, and plus 2 state is ending with IC, that is Hg2+ is reading as mercury and Hg+ is reading as mercurous. Like that we are going to name. Okay. Similarly, so other example, iron will be there, no? Iron will be present in plus 2 state and plus 3 state. Plus 2 state is known as ferrous, plus 3 state is known as ferric. Okay, higher na IC in the enmartivi, lower na OUS in the enmartivi. Ferric and ferrous. Okay, so like stannous and stannic. Stannous under plus 2, stannic under plus 4. Higher is IC, lower is OUS. Next up. So, and few more things we are going to discuss about this positively charged radical. That is, this positively charged radical is also known as cation. Why we call it as cation? Because, so during the electrolysis, this positive ion will be moved towards the cathode. That's why we know as a cation. That means what? What is the meaning of this? Exact meaning of this is, so you know, you might have seen the electrolysis process. What do you mean by electrolysis process? In electrolysis process, what we are going to take up? So an electrolyte, for example, if I take a NaCl, aqueous solution of NaCl and molten solution of NaCl I am going to take, and I am going to take a two electrode, one is acting as anode and another one is acting as a cathode. So anode is connected to positive terminal of the battery, cathode is connected to negative terminal of the battery. Okay, so that this is an electrolytic chamber, that's electrolytic cell. By applying high potential to this electrolyte which we have taken, so this is called anode and this electrode is called a cathode. Okay, so what happens when I apply high voltage or high current to corresponding electrode, whatever the electrolyte, that is whatever the substance that we are going to take here, that will be ionizes into, that NaCl will be dissociates. Dissociates means cleavage. Dissociation means separation. Okay, so that will be separate into, so Na+ and the Cl-. Ions formation agutte. The substance will be ionizes antanu karitare. Because ions are produced now, ionization antanu karitare, but dissociation antanu kuda we will say. After the formation of the ions, after the ionization, what happens? The formed Na+, it is positive iruvudilla, that is attracted towards the negative terminal. Usually, where do we have the negative terminal? Cathode, right? The cation is moved towards where? Cathode, right? So, cations are all the electrode over the name called cathode. All negative ions will be moved towards where? Anode. That's why the name of this electrode as anode. People understanding? That is, during the electrolysis, since the cations are moving towards the cathode of the electrolytic chamber, so also called cation. Positive ion is also known as cation. Same thing I have written here. Positive radical go to the cathode during the electrolysis. That's why known as cation, because cathode is connected to a negative terminal of the external battery. We know that unlike poles will attract each other. That's why positive ion move towards the negative electrode. That is, zero, Na plus and OH minus. So look here, the positive ion is resulting from what? Dissociation of a base. Yes or no? Like for example, KOH. KOH dissociate into K plus and OH minus. Since the cations are resulting due to the dissociation of a base, so also called a basic radical. Okay, so also call it as what a basic radical. So for example, NaOH in the Na plus one is there, KOH in the K plus one is there. So that's why we call it as what a. So since they are resulting from the bases, so called as a basic radical. So not only an atom or an element will be acting as a positively radical. Sometimes a group of atoms are group can also be acting as a positive radical. Example for such radical which acts as a basic one or as the what positively charged radical is ammonium plus NH4 plus. Here the group of atom having positive charge which is acting as a, here it is acting as a basic radical. So it is an example. Okay, it's a group of atom, it is acting as a positively charged radical. Okay, next up. Similarly, negative radical means the species which have a net negative charge on it is known as what? A negative radical. So for example, chlorine, so by releasing, that is by giving out, by the loss of one electron, Cl minus is formed. Oxygen, by the loss of two electron, it forms O2 minus. The net charge is negative. So similarly, so some of the note we are going to discuss about this negative radical also. Negative radical go to where? Here as I explained you in the electrolysis process, after the ionization, the negative charge will go to positive terminal of the battery. The positive terminal is anode, because anode is connected to positive terminal of the external battery, right? Since the negative ions will move towards the anode, these, they are also known as anions. What do we call a negative radicals are also known as anions, since they are moving towards the anode during the electrolysis. And also these radicals obtain from the dissociation of acid, so called acid radical. Okay, so for example, so many examples I have written, Br minus bromide, iodide, nitrite, NO2 can be reading as what? A nitrite, T-R-I-T-E, nitrite. Bicarbonate, this is bisulfate, this is called sulfite, P-H-I-T-E, sulfite we are going to say. And for example, why we call it as acid radical? For example, if H2SO4, we know that H2SO4 is an acid. So dissociation of this acid will be producing 2H plus and the SO4 minus, SO4 2 minus. This is negatively charged radicals are formed from acid, so called acid radical. Similarly, when HCl will be dissociates, it forms H plus and Cl minus. See, this negatively charged radical is formed from acid, so called acid radical. So here briefly I will summarize this. This positively charged radical is also known as what? A cation, since it is moving towards the cathode during the electrolysis. This positively charged radical is also known as basic radical, since these radicals are obtained from the dissociation of the base. Similarly, negative radical is also known as what? Anion, because during the electrolysis they move towards the anode. And also this negatively charged radical is also known as acid radical, because they are formed due to the dissociation of an acid. So all these are examples for that. So here also, not only an element can act as a negatively charged species, a group of atom can also possess a negative charge. Example, nitrite, bicarbonate, bisulfate, sulfite. They are all having group of atoms. So we know that chemistry is full of chemical reactions, right? So in writing the chemical reactions, we are going to take formulas, right? Chemical formulas. Using chemical formulas, we are going to represent the reactants. That reactants react to form a product, right? So in writing the chemical reaction, we should have a knowledge to write how the chemical formulas of the compounds, right? So what do you mean by the chemical formula then? Chemical formula is, it is used to represent a molecule. That molecule may be formed from an element, or that may be element, or may be in the form of compound. That means that may be formed from a types of element. It is called compound, right? It is used to represent a molecule of element or compound in terms of symbols. In terms of using symbols, then it gives the composition of the substance. It gives the composition of the substance. For example, if I take H2SO4, in H2SO4, two atoms of hydrogen will be there, one atom of sulfur will be there, four atoms of oxygen will be there. That is called composition of the H2SO4. Chemistry deals with composition, right? So similarly, let us take H2S. Here, two atoms of hydrogen combines with one atom of the sulfur. That is a composition of hydrogen sulfide. Here also, if I take a sodium chloride, one atom of sodium combines with one atom of chlorine to form sodium chloride. Sodium chloride compositions NaCl, one atom of each. So, that is for sodium chloride. That means, next question is, how to write the chemical formula? So, in order to write the chemical formula, we should follow some steps or some rules. So, what are those rules? Three important rules you have to keep it in the mind while writing the chemical formula of the any compound. That is, first step is, symbol or formula of the cation is written with the valency as a superscript. First, na chemical formula na barivaga yavaglu cation na first barithivi followed by the anion. So cation na barivaga heng baribeku cation na andre cation na symbol. For example, sodium cation andre Na. Na is a what we can say is symbol of that. And plus, that is charge, we have to indicate as a superscript. Symbol or formula of the compound. Symbol and the use part you one element. For example, Na plus, Cl minus, like that. Formula and the group of atom acting as a cation and anion. No? That's why we will say it as formula. That is SO42 minus, like that. So of cation is written with the valency as a superscript. Valency is nothing but charge possessed by that ion. Next, symbol or formula of anion is written with the valency. Cation bada nata anion baribeko, same thing with this valency. So valency should be crossed. Valency is na cross maadi simple formula da baribeko. Okay, simple formula dalle nanu common terms idre a common terms na matte further simplify maadbeko. Let us take one example. How to write sodium oxide? Sodium oxide na hege baribekandre first cation barkoli, cation na symbol barkodidini as Na, matte adu charge na barkodidini the valency of that as 1. No need to write the plus or minus anta indicate maada avashyakate illa while writing the formula. So aagige plus anta barkala just I have taken as 1. Then oxide andre oxygen with its valency as 2, minus 2, minus the neglect maadidini because charge no need to consider. So O2, let us cross the valencies, then we are going to get Na2O. That is, we can write Na and O. The valency of Na is 1, oxygen it is 2, let us do the cross, so then we are going to get Na2O. This is a simple formula. Like this also we can write. Okay. Similarly, so barium sulfate. Barium, the valency of barium is 2 and sulfate minus 2. Minus we are not going to consider. SO42. Do the cross multiplication. Ba2 SO4 twice. 2 is common here. That's why 2 is common factor. Hence we have to divide by 2 for the further simplification. Then we are going to get BaSO4. Similarly, we can write in this fashion also Ba and SO4. The valency is 2. The valency is 2. Do the cross multiplication. We are going to get Ba2SO4. Okay. So Ba2SO4 twice. Then further simplification, it becomes BaSO4. Okay. So like that we are going to write. Similarly, so we can take Al2SO4. Al. So aluminium. So sulfate. Aluminium sulfate. So aluminium. So to charge possessed by this plus 3 and sulfate SO4 2 minus. Do the cross multiplication. I am going to get Al2SO4 thrice. Why? Because so if you do the cross multiplication, we are going to get it. Again. So for example, aluminium and we are going to take sulfate here. The charge of this one is 3. charge of this one is 2. Do the cross multiplication. We are going to get water. Al2SO4 thrice. This is the simplify madakbaranga. This is common term. We will do retain as Al2SO4 thrice. Here formulas baridana you have to know. Okay, we will be taking one table related to this. There we are going to take many examples. Now let us write the formulas of some of the compounds with the help of this table. So sodium, so we know the symbol of the sodium ion is Na+, and with respect to all these ions, that is negative ions, we start writing the formulas of the compounds. What is the formula? So when Na cross the valencies, NaCl. Okay, do the cross with hydroxide. Do the cross multiplication, write the formula. Since both are having valency 1, it is not what we can say, it is not difficult to write, you can easily write. So NaOH will be the formula. Similarly, Na with NO3 minus what we can write, sodium nitrite. NaNO3 nitrite. So similarly with carbonate, valency of carbonate is 2. And valency of Na is +1. Do the cross multiplication. Na2CO3. Ekandre exchange agutte valency alva. What's the formula? Na2Cl. Sodium carbonate. Okay, disodium anta odala. It is sodium carbonate itself. Okay, similarly, sodium with sulfate. So do the cross multiplication. It becomes water. Na2SO4. Sodium sulfate. Disodium sulfate anta ottiva? No, never. Estarlo irlido. So we can name it as sodium sulfate only after writing the formula. Similarly, with PO4 3 minus. How do I do the cross multiplication? 3 sodium ipadutte, sodium do phosphate ipadutte. Cross multiplication. What happens then? Na3PO4. Sodium phosphate. What's the formula? Sodium phosphate. Similarly, we take a second one, potassium. So the formula will be KCl, KOH, potassium chloride, potassium hydroxide. So KNO3, that is potassium nitrite. Similarly, next will be cross multiplication. Do the cross multiplication. K2CO3, potassium carbonate. Next do the cross multiplication. Then K2SO4, that is potassium sulfate. Do the cross multiplication. K3PO4, potassium phosphate. Okay, similarly, next one, magnesium. Look at here, charge is 2. Do the cross multiplication. What happens? 2 in chlorine, the chlorine charge magnesium. If you do the what cross multiplication, then the formula becomes MgCl2. Right? MgCl2. It equal to cross multiplication. So magnesium chloride, or magnesium dichloride. Just say magnesium chloride. Similarly, next magnesium hydroxide, do the cross multiplication. MgOH twice. MgOH twice. Whenever we will be having group of atoms acting as anion, we will be using the brackets for the for our simplicity. Okay. So the group of atoms are the bracket and the it looks good. Okay. So next what happens? Do the cross multiplication. What happens? MgNO3 twice. Okay, so next with the carbonate, 2, this is also valency 2, that is also having valency 2. The formula will be MgCO3, magnesium carbonate. The valencies get what? Balanced. With the 2, this is also, we are also 2. So then the formula will be MgSO4, magnesium sulfate. Here 3 is there and 2 is there. If you get bariyanga sort of confused, you just do what I previously told you, that is PO4. So valency is 2, this is 3. Do the cross multiplication. You can announce it right now. Mg3PO4 twice. Like this. Do this and you can write, no problem. Okay. Now what we can write is, sorry. Yes, correct. Mg3 PO twice. So, this is the valency Mg, but this is ammonium hydroxide NH4OH. Next, ammonium nitrate NH4NO3. Next, carbonate plus 1 is 2 is charge. Plus 1 carbonate 2 NH4 the formula becomes NH4 twice carbonate. Next, with sulfate, the same thing. What happens? NH4 twice sulfate. Yes or no? So with phosphate, 3 is there, plus 1 is there. Again, do the cross multiplication, that is NH4 is there and PO4 is there. So charge is 1 and this charge is 3. Do the cross multiplication, then you are going to get as what? NH4 plus PO4. Okay. So if you get confused, like that, you have to do the cross multiplication and you get right. NH4 plus PO4. ಯಾವಾಗ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ವೆನ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಟಮ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ರಾಡಿಕಲ್ಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಯುಪ್ರಸ್. ವಿ ನೋ ದಟ್ OUS ರೆಫರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಲೋವರ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೇಷನ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್. ದ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ CuCl. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ CuOH. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ CuNO3. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ Cu plus 1 is there, 2 is there. What happens? Cu2, CO3. Okay. Next, what happens? Cu2, SO4. Similarly for phosphate. Phosphate, if you get confused, what you are going to write is? So you can write Cu thrice Q. Cu thrice Q. Okay, then you are going to write. Similarly, so further, hope you are going to complete this table, right? So further, remaining, you can write, take it as a homework, try to write the formulas of the compound by doing the cross multiplication whenever you will get confused. Okay, like this, you should complete this table. Okay, this is homework for you people, just complete and you should know how to write the formulas of the compound. It is very, very basic information in order to write the chemical reactions that you are going to deal in.